Good afternoon. We'd like to start today's briefing for international press on the issues related to TEPCO's Fukushima nuclear power stations and other issues. As you have already seen, there is a report of Japanese government to the IAEA Ministerial Conference on Nuclear Safety that was released 2 days ago in the evening. And I assume that many of you have already seen the document. The entire document itself is very large, and we have already prepared the summary of the report, it is uploaded to the Prime Minister's office website, the English version as well. Let me just introduce today's briefers. My name is Noriyuki Shikata, Deputy Cabinet Secretary for Public Relations of the Prime Minister's office. And to your left is at the center is Mr. Hidehiko Nishiyama, Deputy Director General of NISA. And to his left is Mr. Kenji Kasuga, Director Regional Products and Industrial Crops Office of Minister of Agriculture. And to his left is Mr. Eiichi Okota, Senior Technical Officer, Food Safety Department of MHLW. And from my side to your right is Mr. Tsukasa Kawaguchi, Deputy Director of the Secretariat of the Nuclear Safety Commission. And lastly, to his right is Mr. Takeshi Matsunaga of Ministry of Foreign Affairs. Without further ado, I would like to just ask Mr. Nishiyama to have his initial remarks from NISA.
Hi. Good afternoon, everybody. First, I'd like to briefly introduce the highlights of the the Japanese government's report to IAEA. You have the report in front of you. Please look at page 10. There are some descriptions of how things developed with each unit of Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power stations. On page 10, there is a description about Unit 1. And you can see in the third paragraph, status of the reactor core. There is a description on how the core melting started in the early timing of the accident. And the same kind of description in this document. For example, on page 11, there is a description regarding Unit 2. And page 12, there is a description on Unit 3 of Fukushima Daiichi. And on page 20, chapter 6 is discharge of radioactive materials, discharge to the materials to the environment. And on the second paragraph of parenthesis 1, you can see that by JNES and NISA, our agency, it is estimated that total discharged amount of iodine-131 and cesium-137 were approximately 1.6 times 17th power of 10 becquerel, and 1.5 times 16th power of 10 becquerel respectively. And on, at the top of page 21, there is a sentence that the discharged amount since early April has been declining and is about 11th power of 10 becquerel to 12th power of 10 becquerel in iodine 131 equivalent. This shows the current status of the discharged radioactive materials. And starting at page 27, there are lessons learned from the accident so far. This is a tentative list, but the Japanese government went through the whole process of this accident and identified as many items as possible, even the very difficult areas for the government. And I will not touch upon the detail of each item, but I would like to add one thing, which is this 28 lessons are the scope of our review of nuclear safety regulations. And among them, you may know that NISA, our agency, requested the nuclear power operators in Japan to be prepared for the loss of all AC power sources and heat sink. They already placed pumps and electricity generating cars at high places where even the largest tsunami cannot reach. NISA urged them to train themselves on how to use them, even in the disastrous situations. In addition to the measures to cope with the loss of those power and heat sink, we already requested the nuclear power plant operators to be prepared for severe accidents. Examples are measures to avoid hydrogen explosions and to enhance containment venting system. So we will explain the people in Japan who are afraid of the risk of nuclear power plants that we are taking those measures, and also we will review our nuclear safety regulations based on this list of lessons learned from the accident. And next, I'd like to touch upon very briefly the recent status of each plant of the Fukushima Daiichi. Regarding Unit 1, there is no big change in this unit. During the process of exploring how to reduce high radiation dose in the reactor building of this unit, we found vapor and even 4,000 millisievert spot place. We are thinking how to deal with it. Regarding Unit 2, a spent fuel pool cooling system has been working, and we will open double doors to the reactor building and reduce humidity of the of this building after we've confirmed amount of radioactive materials discharged from the reactor building into the environment. We may use air cleaning machines which trap radioactive materials with filters. After those works, we will inject nitrogen to the containment vessel and will rectify measuring equipment regarding water level. For Unit 3, it is most important to overcome high radiation dose. We are trying to find a spot where we can introduce nitrogen without being disturbed by high radiation dose. At the same time, we will try to rectify water level measuring equipment. Regarding Unit 4, we are constructing a supporting structure of the spent fuel pool. Also, we will repair water injecting line for the spent fuel pool of this Unit 4 so that we can attach a cooling system. As for the stagnant water stored in the radiated waste disposal system, we will begin a test run of a water purifying system, which consists of Areva of France and Curion of the United States machines. This system will start operating at the middle of this month. That's all for my report today. Thank you very much.
Next, I'd like to ask Mr. Tsukasa Kawaguchi of the Nuclear Safety Commission to come up with the opening remarks.
日本語で失礼します。原子力安全委員会事務局でございます。
Allow me to speak in Japanese. I represent the Secretariat for the NSC.
本日はですね、6月8日付で行いました環境モニタリング結果の評価についてご説明させていただきます。
So today I would like to present to you the result of the evaluation of the environmental monitoring that took place as of the 8th of June.
今回はですね、文部科学省から6月6日および7日にですね、公表されました情報に基づく評価でございます。
So this evaluation results is based on the information published by MEXT on the 6th and 7th of June.
状況にですね、大きな変化は特段ございません。
Now there is no major change in the situation.
ポイントを絞ってご説明させていただきます。
So I would like to give you a high-level summary of what requires attention.
まず一番のですね、空間放射線量についてでございますが、福島第一原子力発電所の20キロ圏内におけます放射線量率の測定結果が出ております。
Starting with the ambient radiation dose, we have the result of the measurement within 20 kilometer radius of the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant.
北西方向にですね、比較的高い線量率が現れているところでございますが、この傾向につきましては先週も同じような計測をしておりまして、同様の傾向が見えるところでございます。
Now, in the northwestern direction, the radiation dose was measured to be at a relatively high level, but a same trend has been observed last week, and so this is a similar trend that was observed this week as well.
資料の裏面でございますが、一番上にですね、ストロンチウムの分析結果についての評価の記述がございます。
Now, if you refer to this material distributed by NSC, on the back of this one-page material, there is reference made to the result of the analysis of strontium.
これまでにですね、採取されました土壌の資料のデータにですね、今回ストロンチウムの結果が追加されてございます。
And so the analysis item of strontium had been added to the result of analysis for the soil sample that was adopted this time.
比較的半減期の短いですね、ストロンチウム89が検出されているということからですね、今回のですね、ストロンチウムにつきましては、今回の事故でですね、出てきたというものと考えられるというところでございます。
And since the strontium that was measured is strontium 89, which has a relatively short half-life, this strontium is considered to have been released as a result of the accident.
私からの説明は以上でございます。
So that concludes my initial presentation.
Next, I'd like to ask Mr. H. Yokota of MHLW to speak.
私からは厚生労働省の方に報告になりました食品の検査結果についてご説明いたします。
Now, I would like to report to you the result of the test of food, which has been reported to MHLW.
お手元お配りしている紙の1枚目がこれまでの食品の検査結果の一覧表でございます。
So the first page of MHLW summarizes the result of the testing that had been conducted so far.
このうち6月1日以降暫定規制値超過した例をご紹介させていただきます。
And so I would just like to focus my attention on the food items that had exceeded the provisional limit as of and beyond the 1st of June.
まず一番上の福島県ですけども、こちらの方はタケノコ、シイタケ、梅、それから一部の水産物で暫定規制値超過した例がございました。
So, starting with Fukushima Prefecture on the top, there had been some food samples of bamboo shoot, shiitake mushrooms, plum, and part of the marine products that exceeded the provisional limit.
それからその他の県では茨城県の生茶葉で暫定規制値超過した例がございました。
And for other prefectures in Ibaraki, the raw or undried tea leaves had exceeded the limit in some areas.
ただし、まあ、それ以外の品目でありますか、あとそれ以外の地域の食品については全て暫定規制以下という結果でございました。
However, the food samples that had been obtained in other regions were below this provisional limit.
で次2ページ目以降が現在原子力災害対策本部から指示が出されている、まあ、出荷制限等の一覧表でございます。
And the second page lists up the food items that have a ban imposed on the shipment issued by based on the instructions issued by the Nuclear Emergency Response Headquarters.
こちらも6月以降変更になった部分だけご説明させていただきます。
So, also for this page, I would just like to highlight the changes that had taken place starting from the beginning of June.
まず野菜類の一番上のところですが、6月1日に福島県の一部地域の非結球性葉酸類、ほうれん草などについて出荷制限の方が解除されています。
Starting with vegetables, on the 1st of June, in part of the areas in Fukushima Prefecture, the ban that had been imposed in the past on non-head type leafy vegetables such as spinach had been lifted.
それから下の方に来まして、タケノコですけども、6月8日にいわき市で生産されるものについて、こちらも出荷制限が解除されています。
And going to the bottom of this list, bamboo shoot that is produced in Iwaki City had its ban lifted as of the 8th of June.
それから今度下の方で梅についてはこれ6月2日および6月6日付で新しく出荷制限の指示が出されております。
On the other hand, for plum, that is the ume, on the 2nd and also on the 6th of June, there had been additional instructions issued to pose a ban on the shipment.
それからあと一番下でございますけれども、ヤマメにつきましても、6月6日に一部地域につきまして出荷制限の指示が出されております。
And also for the fishery product, that is the cherry salmon, yamame fish, on the 6th of June, for part of the yamame fish that had been taken and part of the rivers that had been a ban imposed.
それから3ページ目が今度福島以外の地域でございますけども、こちらにつきましては一番下のところですけども、お茶について茨城、栃木、千葉、神奈川の一部につきまして出荷制限の方の指示が6月2日に出されております。
And going on to the third page, which describes these instructions for the shipment restriction in prefectures other than Fukushima, the tea leaf that is at the bottom of this table has the instruction ordered for the restriction of, or rather the ban of shipment of tea leaves in Ibaraki, Tochigi, Chiba, and Kanagawa.
それから最後の4ページ目、こちらは今度接種制限の方でございます。
Then moving on to the fourth page, which describes the restriction of intake instructions.
こちらは変更になったのは1箇所、非結球性葉菜類について6月1日付で一部地域の接種制限の指示が解除されています。
The only change that is seen in this table is the lifting of the restriction of consumption in part of the regions as of the 1st of June concerning the non-head type leafy vegetables.
私の方からの説明は以上でございます。
So that concludes my presentation.
Next, Mr. Kenji Kasuga of Minister of Agriculture, Forestry and Fisheries, please.
農林水産省から今回報告する事項は特にございません。
There is nothing to be reported from MAF. Thank you.
And Mr. Matsunaga from Ministry of Foreign Affairs.
Thank you, Mr. Shikata. Today, I have circulated a document which concerns the 10th.ASEAN Foreign Ministers meeting. The document is chair's statement of the ministers meeting that was held on 6th and 7th of June in Hungary. While the document, this 19-page document itself, is an interesting reading as a whole, I just would like to draw your attention to the only to the relevant part of the document.To the subject of this briefing session, which are paragraph 9 through 12. I would like to invite you to take time to have a look at these paragraphs when you have time. That's all from me. Thank you.
Now I'd like to open the floor for questions. When you have a question, please identify yourself with affiliation and please limit your question to only one. Okay, go ahead.
Ima Dajani, Iris Media, Dubai. Regarding the risk of any new nuclear power points, will you live?With your family near any new nuclear power plants, your answer, I think, will resume and give citizens a clear idea about the safety regulations and procedures.
And thank you. Your question is addressed to Mr. Nishiyama.
イリスメディアアルハーデルから参りましたイマートアジャミでございますけれども、これはこの新たに建設される原子力発電所に関わるリスクについての質問でございます。こういった新しい原発がもしもできて、その近くに自分の家族と一緒に住むかどうかということを考える際に、当然、政府側から明確な安全に関する規制、あるいは安全性を担保するための手続きについて、説明が必要だと思いますけれども、これについてはいかがでしょうか。
はい、先ほど私は この IAEA に関する IAEA に関するレポートでも説明しましたけれども、まず、日本政府がこれから安全に関して見直していく行こうと考えているポイントがこのレッスンズラウンドのところにまず出ています。
So, as I have mentioned earlier concerning the contents of the IAEA report, in part of this lessons learned in this report, there are aspects that the Japanese government are planning to thoroughly review.
そのうちで、冷却機能が今回と同様の津波で失われた場合、あるいはその電源が失われた場合などについても冷却機能を維持できるように各原子力発電所が備えをもうしております。
So in order to be fully prepared for a tsunami of a similar scale that may totally deprive the cooling function that is usually an operation in nuclear power plants, or in case there is a power supply loss as a result of these tsunami, there is a procedure established for all nuclear power plants to implement, which indeed has already been implemented, to make sure that the cooling system and the cooling function of the power plants would not be lost even at time of such emergency.
それからこのレポートが出た後、我々NISAはそれに加えて、仮にシビアアクシデントになった場合でも、例えば水素の爆発を防ぐとか、あるいはヴェンティングをうまくできるようにするとか、そういう対策を今後素早く取るように各電力会社に指示をしています。
And after this report had been compiled, on top of what is described in this report, NISA have given instructions to all nuclear power operators to take necessary set of measures to make sure that hydrogen explosion would be prevented and to make sure that venting can be carried out smoothly even when there is a severe accident.
でそういう対策を取っているので、今日本にある原発は安全だということについて、我々はよく地元の人々にその原発がある地域の人々に説明を今しようとしているところです。まあ、しているところです。
So, since we are taking these set of measures, we are now in a process to explain to the local citizens in the local community and the vicinity of the existing nuclear power plants in Japan that nuclear power plants are safe.
Christoph?
Follow up on that question. Christoph Neider, Süddeutsche Zeitung, Germany. Question for Mr. Nishiyama and Mr. Kawaguchi. NISA has reviewed the regulations for safety since the 1970s, again and again, last time after the Kashiwazaki-Kashima problem. Now, what gives the Japanese people...the confidence that this time it will be different. There's no, you have reviewed and reviewed and you had accidents again and again and accidents that were worse than before. Why should the Japanese people believe that this time it is different? And then second question, the most dangerous problem right now are the spent fuel pools. Now there is no solution to the spent fuel pools.Because you don't have any space where you can final storage of spent fuel. So in a way, the most dangerous problem cannot be solved. Is that correct? And then, wouldn't Japan is the country with 20% of all earthquakes in the world. There are several European countries that phase out nuclear power. Don't you think this would be the right solution for Japan too? Thank you.
ドイツの新聞、シュトツズートングのクリストフ・ナイハートでございますが、フォローアップの質問をさせていただきたいと思います。これは西山さんと川口さんに、伺いたい質問ですけれども、日本の原子力安全保安院は安全性に関するさまざまな規制あるいは基準というのを70年代以来繰り返し繰り返し、見直し検討し、そして例えば鹿島原発の事故などが結局は起こって、そしてまた再び見直しをして今回の重大事故が発生しているので、日本の国民が今回こそは違う安全であるということを、こういった繰り返し規制を見直し、それでもまた事故が起こるという状況を今まで見てきて、信じることができるんでしょうか。それから2番目の質問は、使用済み燃料プールに関して、ソリューションがないというふうに私は思っています。というのは最終的にこういった使用済み燃料を貯蔵するスペースというのがないわけですから、一番危険性の高いこの問題に対する解決策というのは見出すことができないというふうに思いますけれども、それについてはいかがでしょうか。それから次に、世界の地震の 20% は日本で起こると言われています。で、現に今ヨーロッパの国の中で段階的に原発を撤廃するという決定を下した国があるわけですけれども、日本もやはり同様の政策を取るべきだとは思わないでしょうか。以上です。
はい、まず私の方からお答えしたいと思いますけれども、NISA はこれまで、新しく得られた知見に基づいて、その時点では一番いいと思われる規制を実行してまいりました。
So first of all, allow me to answer your question. What NISA has been doing so far in reviewing the regulation to set new safety standards was based on the latest set of wisdom and information that NISA had managed to gather at that specific point in time.
それでこれまでの間は今回の福島の事故を除くと、こういうシビアアクシデントに当たるようなことは一回も起こったことがありません。で、柏崎刈羽の場合もあれほど大きな地震にあっても原子炉が正常に止まって、燃料に影響があるようなことはありませんでした。
And so except for this Fukushima nuclear power plant incident, we have never in the past experienced a severe accident of this scale and of this nature. So even when there had been an incident in Kashiwazaki Kariwa, a nuclear power station, there had been a normal shutdown of the nuclear reactors and there was no breach of nuclear fuel.
ただ今回はこういうシビアアクシデントが起こってしまったので、先ほど申し上げたようなシビアアクシデントに対する、それを起こさないような対策と、それから起きてしまった時の対策を新たに付け加えております。
Now, this time what we have encountered is a severe nuclear accident. So as I have explained to you earlier, we are now introducing this set of measures to, first of all, try to prevent the occurrence of such severe accidents. And also we have in place a set of measures to address the severe accident if in case it would become a reality.And minimize the damage.
今回はこの報告書、 IAEA の報告書の中にありますように、それに加えてこの NISA を、経済産業省から独立させて、その事業者を育成する役割と切り離した形の、規制を取ろうという考え方を新たに示しています。
And as mentioned in this report to the IAEA, a decision has been made this time to separate NISA totally from METI and make it an independent body so that the role of regulating these nuclear power plants would be totally separated from the function of the government to promote and develop these nuclear power plant operators.
2番目の使用済み燃料プールについては、これを的確に、災害に 襲われた場合でもそのこれを的確に冷却することができればあのシビアアクシデントは防げると思っております。
Now to answer your second question concerning the spent fuel pool, even when there is a disaster that may take place in the campus of the nuclear power plant, if we can continue the appropriate level of cooling, then we can prevent a major damage incurred from the spent fuel pool.
それからあのこの新しくできるプラントについてはあの使用済み燃料プールの場所などについてもあの設置場所などについても検討するということがこの IAEA の報告書の中にも書かれています。
And for the new nuclear power plants, the location within the nuclear power plant where the spent fuel pool should be constructed is indicated in this IAEA report.
最後のポイントはあの私の今の直接の担当ではありませんけれども、今、この原子力発電所以外に発電の、その発電のやり方を考えるとすると、まあ、あの再生可能エネルギーがあの現状ではまだあの十分、信頼できない、信頼できないというのかその、安定的でない状況を考えると原子力を使わない以上はあの化石燃料の、発電に依存せざるを得なくなります。
Now, although I am not directly responsible for the point that you have mentioned in your third question, one thing that I can say is if we are to consider other power sources for electricity not depending on nuclear energy, then since at this point in time renewable energy is not a stable source of power supply, we have to instead of nuclear energy have to depend on fossil fuel.
で、その場合は、2008年に見られたような、燃料の価格の高騰ということになって、これは日本経済があの立ち行かないことを意味しております。
However, if we are to depend ourselves on fossil fuel, when there is a sudden soar of energy prices, as we have witnessed in 2008, this would give a major negative impact on the Japanese economy.
したがって、まだこれからあの日本国内でも議論をしますけれども、あの原子力の可能性については、あの今相当、なあの議論が必要だと思っています。
So therefore, although we need to have an extensive discussion on the future energy policy within this country, we have to still seriously think about the potential and the viability of the use of nuclear energy in this country.
え、原子力安全委員会事務局でございます。原子力安全委員会ではですね、安全規制に関わるその今一次行政規制庁である、安全保安院さんが行いました、安全規制に対してダブルチェックを行うという観点からですね、またあの安全規制の基本的考え方というのをですね示すという立場でございます。それでですね、我々はその安全審査等に関わるまあ様々なガイドラインというのを、策定してきたところでございます。
So I would like to answer your question from the point of view of the Secretariat of NSC. Now, the Nuclear Safety Commission is in a position to double-check the result of the regulation that is conducted by NISA, which is positioned as the primary administrative body of this country to oversee the nuclear power-related activities. And so we have shown the basic principles concerning the safety regulations, and we have introduced, or rather established and introduced a guideline that was compiled by NSC concerning the evaluation of the safety level of the nuclear power plants.
例えばですね、耐震の部分でありますればですね、常にですね、最新の、知見やですね、そういう科学的な、見解などをですね、反映するようにということは、示してきているところではございます。
So, for example, in the nuclear preparedness against these seismic shocks or earthquakes, we have shown guidelines that require full account of the latest wisdom and knowledge as well as the scientific understanding to be fully taken into account for the anti-seismic preparedness.
一方でですね、今回の、地震及び津波によりまして、全電源喪失等のですね、事象が起きたということは、事実でございます。
Having said so, it is indeed true that as a result of the earthquake and the ensuing tsunami this time, there was a total loss of power.
今回のことでですね、その、例えば我々が作ります、ガイドライン等にですね、不十分な面が、あったということは、否めないというふうに認識しておるところでございます。
So, as a result of this incident, we have come to realize that there were insufficiencies in the guideline that we have been formulated up to now.
このことにつきまして、十分、反省をした上でですね、今後、我々の方でですね、実際に我々今、作ってございます、安全審査のガイドライン等の見直しについてですね、検討をしていきたいというふうに考えているところでございます。
And so based on full reflection of our work and the possible shortfalls of what we have been doing up to now, we are going to fully review the guideline that we have compiled so far concerning the safety examination of nuclear power plants.
Just let me supplement what Mr. Nishiyama said in relation to your...third question. As you are probably aware, Prime Minister Kan, when he attended the G8 Deauville summit, he made it clear that the Japan will add, in addition to fossil fuel and nuclear power, two additional pillars of energy policy, which are renewable energy and saving energy. And Mr. Kan,expressed his intention to try to increase proportion of renewable energy in the Japanese power or energy mix by aggressively introducing such technologies as solar power and with the aim of introducing over 20% of power generations as early as possible in the 2020s.But at the same time, we are not saying that you know, we will be getting rid of nuclear power option, and we need to have a realistic energy mix in terms of discussing our future energy policy. And of course, Mr. Kan has already mentioned that Japan would intend to review energy basic policy.From scratch, and this is going to be the ongoing issue for discussion and debate in this country about the future of energy policy. And I would just like to note that, for example, as you mentioned, maybe some countries in the world are getting rid of nuclear energy as a the power generation option, but.There is a realistic, or the reality that as a region, there is a inevitable, you know, need for nuclear power generations as you see in Europe. Thank you.
Petra Kolonko, Frankfurter Allgemeine Zeitung. I also have a question concerning the fuel pool. We still don't know exactly what's wrong with the pool in number four. You kept saying it needs to be reconstructed or reaffirmed or something. What exactly needs to be done and what is the danger there? Why does it have to be reconstructed? And my other question is, and also, has the work started yet or not? Because that was also not quite clear last time. The other question is concerning the tea. As I could see on the list, the tea is relatively new. The restrictions on the tea are relatively new, like on the 2nd of June. So I wonder if any of your experts have an idea why the tea seems to be contaminated now, relatively late. And if you have any explanation why that is, and why the tea, for example, is contaminated in areas as far away as Kanagawa. Thank you.
すいません、お名前をちょっと聞き逃したんですが、フランク、ペトラ・フランク・アルゲマイナー、コロンバスさん、すいません。私も使用済み燃料プールについて、特に、この4号機の建屋の使用済み燃料プールについて、まだ何がまずくて、どうしなければいけないかということが、はっきりと分かっていないように思いますので、伺いますけれども、まあ、どういう問題があって、その補修あるいはこれをまあ立て直すというかリコンストラクションという言葉を使っていらっしゃいますけれども、その補修あるいは改修をしなければいけないのか、その作業というのは実際にスタートしたんでしょうか、もうそもそもその問題はどこにあるんでしょうかという最初のご質問です。それから茶葉について出荷制限が6月2日割と最近になってで、このお茶に関しては、出荷制限がかかっていますけれども、ここにいらっしゃるエキスパートの方でお分かりになれば教えていただきたいんですが、まあ、かなり時期が経って、しかも神奈川のようなかなり原発からは離れたところで、今になってお茶の葉が汚染されるのか、その辺のまあメカニズムが分かれば教えていただきたいと思います。失礼、フランクフルタアルゲマイネのペトラ・コロンコさんからのご質問です。
まず4号機の使用済み燃料プールについては、かなり最近まで、状況がよく分からなかったところがあって、いろいろ皆様に心配いただきましたけれども、結局は今は水もあるし、水の中に使用済み燃料があって、使用済み燃料はあまり壊れていないということが分かりましたので、基本的にはほとんど問題がありません。
So to answer your first question concerning the spent fuel pool of unit number 4, so we indeed have inconvenienced you and have given you some source of concern until very recently concerning the status of the spent fuel pool of unit number 4, because the situation surrounding unit 4 and the spent fuel pool was not fully known until very recently. But we have already found out that there is water in the pool, and that the spent fuel is soaked in the water, that there is no problem in the spent fuel pool.
ただ4号機も建屋ビルディングが壊れてかなり壊れているので、その一番高いところにある使用済み燃料プールが毎日こう崩れるといけないので、今それを支える仕組みを作り始めています。
However, the building of unit number 4 had been damaged quite extensively, which still gives us a concern of the possibility of the spent fuel pool, which is located on the top of the building, to collapse. So in order to prevent such a situation, we are now trying to come up with a certain mechanism to bolster the bottom of the spent fuel pool in order to prevent such collapse.
ただ念のために言いますと、地震の専門家の解析に分析によると、これが崩れる心配はそのリスクはほとんどないというふうなにことなんですけれども、念のため下から支える補強をするということです。
However, I would like to assure you that according to the analysis of an earthquake expert, the probability of the spent fuel pool collapsing as a result of the damaged structure of this building is almost nil. But just to make sure, we are trying to reinforce the bottom of the spent fuel pool.
お茶の汚染のメカニズムにつきましてですが、農林水産省といたしまして、このメカニズムを考察するために、茶葉とそれからその茶園の土壌を採取しまして分析を行いました。
In order to clarify the mechanism of contamination of tea leaves, we have, as a Ministry of Agriculture, Forestry and Fisheries, have obtained samples of the tea leaves as well as the soil of these tea leaf orchards.
その結果、土壌中の放射性セシウムの濃度はそれほど高くないということが分かりました。また、古い葉っぱに含まれている放射性セシウム濃度が、かなり高い値を示しているということが分かりました。
And as a result of the analysis, we have found out that the radioactive cesium concentration in the soil was not that high. And we found out that comparing the tea leaves and the age, if you will, of the tea leaves, the relatively old tea leaves had higher concentration of radioactive cesium.
大量の放射性物質が放出されたのは3月の中旬ということでございますが、その時にはお茶の新芽は出ていない時期でございます。
Now, the timing of a large release of radioactive substances is reported to have taken place around the middle of March. And around that time, no new leaves of tea had been burgeoning.
従いまして、私どもといたしましては、今回、お茶の葉で検出された放射性セシウムは土壌から吸収されたものではなくて、古い葉に付着したものが葉面から吸収されて新芽に移動したものというふうに推定しております。
And therefore, the forecast or the estimation that we came up concerning how the tea leaves have come to be contaminated was that this radioactive cesium was not absorbed from the soil, but rather the cesium that had rested on the relatively old tea leaves had been absorbed through the surface of the leaf and had been migrated over to the new tea leaves.
Thank you. Azhari, Pan Orient News. I read in the Yomiuri Shimbun website in English yesterday that it says nuclear fuel in three reactors at the Fukushima Daiichi plant has possibly melted through pressure vessels and accumulated.At the bottom of outer containment vessels. So my question, I don't want to go to the technical aspects. What does that mean in terms of future radiation in the environment, in the land and the sea and in the air? And if, I don't know who would answer this question, and other short follow-up, whatHow can you describe the situation in Tokyo now in terms of radiation? I mean, I have a long list here, but if you summarize it for me, what's the situation in Tokyo, that would be appreciated. Thank you very much.
パンオリエントニュースのカルド・アザリですけれども、私は読売新聞のウェブで英語版のウェブサイトのニュースで、3つの原子炉の核燃料というのが圧力容器の下からもうそこを、その圧力容器の下が底が抜けてしまって溶け出して、そしてそこ外側にある格納容器の底部に溜まっているということを読んだんで、技術 的な細かいところはわからないんですけれども、これが将来的なその空気中あるいは陸地あるいは海域における放射能汚染にどういった影響を及ぼすのか、将来のこの環境中の放射能の影響がどうなるのかということを簡単に解説していただけないでしょうか。これは具体的にどなたに伺ったらいいか私自身はわかりませんのでよろしくお願いいたします。それからこう東京の放射能のレベルに関して、かなりまあ長いその測定値のリストをいただいていますけれども、簡単にまとめると今の東京の、放射性、物質放射能のレベルっていうのはどういう状況にあると言えるんでしょうか。
まず最初のご質問については、燃料は溶けていて、それで相当部分はプレッシャードベッセルの底の部分にあって、一部はまだもともとの燃料の場所にも残っているいて、それからごく一部がプレッシャードベッセルの底からコンテインメントベッセルの底に落ちている可能性があるというような状況だと思います。
Now, I would like to answer your first question concerning the possible melting of the nuclear fuel. So a sizable amount of the nuclear fuel are staying at the bottom of the pressured vessel, and still some of the fuel are in the place intact, in place intact, and so they are remaining in the place that originally should be where the nuclear fuel should rest. And so it's only a very small portion of the nuclear fuel that had gone through the bottom of the pressure vessel and is now on the bottom of the containment vessel.
それで、これらの割合なりがどういう形であっても、今のように水をずっと絶え間なく入れて冷やしている限りは放射性物質の放出には影響はないと思っています。
Now, irrespective of the proportion of the nuclear fuel in terms of where it is positioned, as long as we continue injection of the water like what we are doing at the moment for sufficient cooling of nuclear fuel, I believe that there would be no impact on the level of radioactive material in the environment.
で、現在の放射性物質の放出量は最初に水素爆発が起こってたくさんの放射性物質が出た頃に比べると、その1000分の1とか1万分の1といったオーダーに小さくなっています。
And the current level of release of radioactive material is far lower than the level that was observed at the time of the hydrogen explosion, when a massive amount of radioactive material was released into the environment. Right now, the level is about 1 over 1,000 or 1 over 10,000 compared to the massive release.Of radioactive material at the time of the hydrogen explosion.
Tokyo の放射線線量率について答えさせていただきます。
So I would like to answer your question regarding the radiation dose rate in Tokyo.
これは文部科学省の方でですね行っている調査でありますが、各都道府県のですね環境放射能水準調査というものがございまして、これは毎回同じ場所で定点観測をしているデータが出てきているところでございます。
And so what I am going to share with you is the result of the monitoring that was carried out by MEXT in all the prefectures. And this is regarded as the environmental radiation level survey. And this is a measurement of the radiation level from the fixed monitoring post.
でご質問、東京都につきましては、最近のデータでいきますと、約ですね 0.06 マイクロシーベルトパーアワーという、値が出てきているところでございます。
And concerning the radiation level in Tokyo, based on the recent monitoring result, the radiation level is at 0.06 microsievert per hour.
でこの値につきましては、過去のですね、平常値の範囲というのがありまして、この中の、範囲に収まっているというものでございます。
Now, this is within what is regarded as the normal range of radiation.
And just for your information, I guess in terms of international comparison, the Tokyo's level is not significantly higher.Than places like New York, London, or some of the figures we find in Hong Kong is higher than in Tokyo. So of course, there is a natural radiation level unique to those specific geographical conditions.
I'd like to, Sito Jitsai in Germany, I'd like to follow up to my on my previous question. Mr. Koguchi, you said there were insufficient guidelines. Now, we all know that the guidelines were insufficient, but we also know that those insufficient guidelines were not met by the utilities, including TEPCO and Chubu Electric. And the TEPCO and Chubu Electric did everything to fight against standards and stricter standards. And your very Mr. Madarame, who is actually the head of your commission, was an expert helping Chubu Electric to fight against stricter standards in Hamaoka. So how should the Japanese people believe that this is not repeating itself, that all, even if you have better guidelines or stricter guidelines, the utilities will not fight back, and the authorities, including the courts, will collude with that. And the other question is a technical question concerning Block 1. We had a meltdown within 4 or 5 hours, and you still seem to believe that this was a cooling problem.So it was a tsunami problem and not a problem caused by the earthquake already. Is that possible that you have a meltdown because of lack of cooling within 4 or 5 hours? Previously you said it's about, it keeps cold, cold enough for about 10 hours or so. Thank you.
再びクリストフ・ナイハートでございますけれども、これは川口さんにまず伺いたい質問で、先ほどのご説明の中で今まで原子力安全委員会が出してきたガイドラインが不十分であったということを今回認識したとおっしゃいましたけれども、私どももうすでにそのガイドラインが不十分であったということは承知しています。ただその不十分なガイドラインでさえ、この電力各社、これは東京電力はじめ中部電力などは、それを十分に、不十分なガイドラインを満たしていない状況にあったということも私たちは知っています。そして、むしろこういったそのガイドライン基準を厳しく、基準を導入するにあたって、東電あるいは中部電力などは、それに、立ち向かって抵抗したということを聞いていますが、現にその安全委員会の委員長でいらっしゃいますマダラメ委員長はエキスパートとして、例えば中部電力が、浜岡原発においてこういった厳しい基準を成就することに対して中部電力が、抵抗する、ある意味、お手伝いをなさっていたという理解をしています。ですから再び同じことの繰り返しにならないということをどうやって日本の国民は納得することができるのか、今回は厳しいガイドラインに改めてこの厳格な安全基準を間違いなく電力各社がそれぞれの原発において守っていく、そして日本の裁判所もはじめ、日本の国の機関というものが、その厳格なこの遵守というものを確保していくということを、なさるんでしょうか。それについて伺います。それからもう一度その1号機の炉心溶融に関して伺いたいんですけれども、 この4、5時間ですでに、まあ、津波が来てから 4,5 時間で炉心溶融がスタートしたというふうに情報が出てきていますけれども、こうそんなことがありえるんでしょうか。たった4時間から5時間十分な冷却が行わないということで、すでに炉心が溶けてしまうということがありえるのか、その辺がよく分かりません。まあ、十分にその10時間ぐらい、まあ、冷却があったというようなお話も伺ってますし、その辺の事実関係を確認させてください。
まずガイドラインの遵守に関してでございますが、まず斑目委員長の発言については直接すみません、私の方存じ上げてございませんので、特にちょっとコメントは差し控えさせていただきます。
So to answer your first question concerning the possible compliance or ensuring the compliance of the stricter guidelines, and I would have to clarify at the beginning that concerning what Mr. Madarame, the committee chair, had said or done personally is not something that I am privy to, so allow me to refrain from making a comment on Mr. Madarame's action.
まあ、いずれにしてもですね、我々が、お示ししている、まあ、ガイドラインや指針ですね、これに基づきまして、まず、原子力安全保安院の方でですね、具体的に、まあ、どういう規制をかけるかというものを、した上で、特にその電力会社に対するですね、指示や指導というものにつきましては我々は直接する立場ではございませんので、そこは、現時代のその規制のあり方という意味でおいて言うならば、原子力安全保安院の方でですね、適切なですね、指導、なり指示がなされているものというふうに考えているところでございます。
Now, the guideline that NSC is to compile or has compiled up to now is something that we refer to NISA for them to come up with concrete and specific regulations based on this guideline. And so the issuance of actual instructions or guidance to the nuclear power plant operators is not within our jurisdiction. I believe that concerning the necessary set of instructions or guidance to the utilities concerning the compliance of the currently existing regulation is sufficiently conducted by NISA.
で、まあ、これからのですね、安全規制の体制のあり方というのはまさにこれから見直しが行われるというふうに聞いているところでございますので、その中でそういった面についても、何かしらの議論が行われるのではないかというふうに認識しているところでございます。
Now, for the future safety regulation, we are now in the state of having to thoroughly review the existing safety regulation for the betterment. And so I'm quite sure that there will be extensive discussion concerning the points that need to be taken into account.
安全委員会の方がおっしゃったように、我々 NISA が、規制を事業者に対して何て言いますか、当てはめてきました。
So, as the Secretariat of NSC had just mentioned, NISA was and is still in a position to apply the regulation to the operators.
おそらくどの国でも規制をされる側の事業者というのは規制には抵抗をし、なるべくその、コストのかからない対応をしたいというふうに望むものだと思います。
Now, I believe that in any country in the world, not only Japan, the operators who are in a position to be imposed of a set of regulations would initially try to resist and fight such regulation and would try to come up with the lowest cost solution.
しかし、これまで、NISA はそういうことに対して妥協したことはないと思っています。
However, I am quite confident that NISA up to now have never made a compromise in that area.
で、そういうことで40年間特に、まあ、大きな事故もなくやってきたわけです。
And by doing so for the past 40 years, we have managed to not witness any severe nuclear incidents.
まあ、しかし今回あのこういう事故があの、まあ、なんて言いますか歴史上最大ともいえる津波によって起こったことからあの我々としてはこの IAEA のレポートに書いてあるようなあの全面的な見直しをしようとしているところです。
Having said so, we have now witnessed this very major scale accident, which was brought forth by this unprecedented tsunami in history. And that is why we have mentioned in this IAEA report that we are to carry out a thorough full-scale review.
あと1号機の、あの、炉心の溶融については確かにあの NISA の解析によると、冷却機能が失われてから、5時間ぐらいの後にはもう溶融が始まったということになっています。
Now, concerning this core meltdown of unit number one, as you have pointed out, according to the analysis of NISA, we presume that about 5 hours after the cooling function has been lost, the melting of the core had been initiated.
それでこれがあの、まあ、この方の原子炉の何か、について改良を必要とするものであるのかとか、それからどういう、手段で、これからこの種のシビアアクシデントを防いだらいいのかということについては、あの これから検討することになります。
And so based on what had happened, we are going to start this study and review of whether there would be improvements required for this same type of reactor in other nuclear power plants, or how we can avoid recurrence of similar incidents in the future.
Given the time, I would like to conclude today's briefing. Thank you very much for coming.